Before Jesse Reyez would team up with Black for their hit single Imported. Before Jesse Reyez would help write the hit songs One Kiss and Promises by Calvin Harris and be featured on two songs with Eminem.
Calvin Harris.
Yeah.
His album comes out.
Yeah.
You're featured on.
Yeah. He was there yesterday. Yeah.
Before Jesse Reyez would be literally at the right place at the right time, which would lead to her working with King Louis.
And then at the end, though, his manager was like, yo, King Louis fucks with your stuff. We should work. But we're leaving tomorrow, so it needs to happen soon.
Before Jesse Reyez would win the Juno Award for R&B and Soul Recording of the Year, Jesse Reyez is taking the music world by storm. With her unique sound and music writing ability, Reyez is finally starting to see the success, which seems to be long overdue. Helping write for popular Calvin Harris songs such as One Kiss and Promises, Reyez's talent really shines when she picks up her guitar and sings from the heart, something she's been doing since her youth. After moving from Toronto to Florida, then back to Toronto, Reyez has had quite the journey leading up to her success in the industry, which includes a Juno for R&B Soul Recording of the Year. We're going to tell you guys all about Jesse Reyez's rise to fame here for you on Before They Were Famous. What's poppin', guys? Jared Bronstein here for you today on Before They Were Famous. If this is your first time here on our channel, welcome. We make videos on celebrities, athletes, musicians, and more on their rise to success and fame. Be sure to subscribe so you guys never miss a video. And as always, let us know in the comments down below who you guys would like to see us document next. A handful of you guys have asked for this one, but before we jump into it, today's trivia question is, what team did Reyez cheerlead for before becoming such a successful musician? You gotta let me know in the comments down below, and as always, find out at the end of our video. Hey, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell. Boom! Jesse Reyez was born on June 12th, 1991 in Toronto, Canada. Both of her parents moved to Toronto from Colombia, where her mother was a preschool teacher before becoming a babysitter in the six. Reyez's dad would play guitar, which Jesse would eventually steal after finding her passion and love for music. Jesse also has an older brother who she credits bringing reggae into her life. But Jesse's love for music all started when she used to sit in front of her TV singing along to opera.
My mom said that she caught me like just looking at the TV and like singing opera. That's when she noticed that I had like an inclination for it.
Jesse's earliest memory is when she would reenact performances by Celia Cruz for her family, getting dressed up and putting fruit in her hair to try to resemble the Latina sensation. She would also play on what she called a little piano, but studied hip-hop dance throughout high school before realizing she was destined to entertain the world with her musical talents. Jesse's family would move from Toronto to Brampton, a city just 20 minutes northwest of Toronto, where she would spend most of her child and teenage years. She claimed while in high school her passion for dancing would take her away from her academic studies. After finishing school around 3 p.m., Jesse would go right to dance practice at 6:30 until about 9 p.m., return home at midnight, and then try to finish her homework before having to get up the next morning at 7 a.m. Throughout her high school years, she fell in love with her boyfriend at the time, but that would eventually encourage her to start writing about real pain, at least according to Reyez herself. At 17 years old, Reyez would find out her boyfriend would be continuing his education in another country, ultimately leading to the end of their relationship. She told Vice, I quote, me and him got together and fell in love, and when it went to when I was 17, it hit me hard as f-. That's when I started to write about real pain, I guess.
I like to say it's like violent soul music. I like to say it's like Quentin Tarantino music, because I aim to be cinematic in the world.
While pursuing music, she'd work odd jobs such as babysitting, teaching dance, and working at Pizza Pizza, as well as a cheerleader, but we'll cover that at the end of this video. But this girl would be straight hustling. While working her odd jobs, she'd be thinking about music and even carrying around her mixtapes in a bag, just in case the opportunity would arise where she could hand it to someone important. She'd begin performing her music in local Toronto clubs and around the streets of the city, but would soon find out her family was making their move to Florida, which was their goal from the get-go. Unfortunately, it's not easy to get into the US as an immigrant, so Toronto was just a layover, albeit for 18 years for Jesse and her family, until they could legally move down south. This would give Jesse an ultimatum: move down south with the family or stay in Canada living alone. She decided she was sticking with the fam jam.
I was born in Toronto, Jane and Driftwood roots, and then I moved to Brampton, and then after Brampton I moved to Florida, Fort Lauderdale, and then I moved back to Toronto.
Eventually she would move back to Toronto, but while in Florida she came to the realization that she had stopped focusing on her music. While down south she picked up a job bartending and was making pretty good money. But she came to the realization she couldn't live this way forever. She said, I ended up moving to Miami and bartending, but the party atmosphere is a black hole down there. People party all the time, and if you're working in the industry, you're sleeping all day and at the club all night, day after day. I did that for a year. I completely neglected my music. The only musical thing I did was playing the guitar at the beach when everyone was coming down after a long night.
Making her late night television debut performing figures, please welcome Jessie Reyez!
She would also work busking on the beach, but her breakthrough as a musician wouldn't come until she got a friend in Miami to help her shoot a music video for one of her songs she recorded while still living in Toronto. Out of fear that it would take someone too long to edit her video, she took it upon herself to get it done. Keep in mind, she never had any experience editing, so she explains how it took her 48 hours to edit a 3-minute video. But it could have been the best possible decision she ever made. After finishing her edits, Reyez sent the final cut to everyone on her Facebook friends list, and one of the people that she sent it to encouraged Jessie to apply to Toronto's Remix Project, a program that was created in order to help level the playing field for young people from marginalized and underserved communities. Our programs and services serve youth who are trying to enter into the creative industries or further their formal education. The Remix Project provides top-notch alternative creative educational programs, facilitators, and facilities. Our mission is to help refine the raw talents of young people in order to help them find success as participants define it and on their own terms. That is directly from the Remix Project website, and that would eventually lead to the start of her career.
The music's sick. He's like, do you know what the Remix Project is? Like, this would be great for you. And at that time, I was literally just bartending and busking on the beach. You know?
After being accepted into the Remix Project, Jessie came back to Toronto to really pursue music full time. Why am I saying it like that? Toronto. It's Toronto. This is where she would be mentored by tons of musicians, including Daniel Daly, which is one half of the OVO signed duo Division. King Louis, a Chicago rapper, was also mentoring while Jessie was attending. It was there that he would hear some of her music, thanks to Gavin Shepherd, co-founder of the Remix Project and founder of Public Records, who is in partnership with Universal Music. It just so happened that Jessie was walking by while they were listening to her track. This would eventually lead to Louis wanting to work on a track with Jessie, which would end up happening at a local condo, more specifically on the condo's balcony.
And we ended up on the balcony, and then that's where that song was born. In an hour's time, they had to leave back to Chicago, and he was like, yo, send me that. And we'll make something work.
This would eventually turn into the track Living in the Sky, which would put Reyez on the map in the music scene. Reyez would then drop her second single, It Hurts, Selena, in 2015. Then in early 2017, she dropped the song Shutter Island. Following Shutter Island, Toronto rapper Party Next Door would announce his European tour and his opening act, Jessie Reyez. After the tour, Reyez would drop her single, Figures, which premiered on Beats One Radio. Figures peaked at number 58 on the Canadian Hot 100 and has since been certified double platinum.
Figures was a time capsule of a breakup that I went through, and I was just going through it and crying and sad and happy to be away from home because I was across the pond in Europe at the time, and I was given the opportunity to just let it out on the mic.
Now at the time of this recording, the Figures music video has 47 million views on YouTube, Jessie has 1.3 million followers on Instagram, and just under 100,000 followers on Twitter. In April of 2017, Jessie would release her debut EP, Kiddo, and a short film to the song Gatekeeper, which Reyez would later explain was inspired by a traumatic night she experienced with Noel Detail Fisher, a successful producer in the music industry. She tweeted out, one night over 6 years ago, Noel Detail Fisher tried this on me. I was lucky and I got out before it got to this. I didn't know what to say or who to tell. I was scared. Fear is a real thing. The girls that came out are brave as hell. Accompanied by a TMZ article headlined Music Producer Detail Accused of Raping, Abusing Two Female Artists. Billboard would name Reyez one of the top 10 hip-hop and R&B artists to watch in 2018, and for good reason. She would win Breakout Artist of the Year at the Juno Awards and be nominated for R&B Soul Recording of the Year, Video of the Year for Gatekeeper, and Juno Fan Choice Award. Although she'd only win the one Juno, this momentum would help Reyez release her second EP, Being Human in Public, and spawn a tour across North America. Reyez would come out strong in 2019, winning the Juno for R&B Soul Recording of the Year, collaborating with Eminem on the songs Nice Guy and Good Guy from his album Kamikaze, and appear in the soundtrack for the movie 50 Shades Freed. She most recently dropped a single with Black titled Imported, and has a cameo in the Netflix film Someone Great. Reyez credits her parents as inspiration for encouraging her music career, and one day hopes to work with the likes of Kid Cudi and Frank Ocean.
I want to work with Kid Cudi and Frank Ocean, okay? If everyone could just put that into the universe.
Well, we're just gonna have to wait and see if her dreams of working with Cuddy and Ocean ever come true, but I wouldn't doubt it. Still very early on in her career, Reyes has worked with the likes of Calvin Harris, Eminem, and Black, as we previously mentioned in the video. It seems year after year her talents continue to shine, and although it didn't come easy, it seems Reyes is going to have many more successful years ahead of her. Now, before we wrap this video up, of course we have to answer our trivia question: which team did Reyes cheerlead for before she became the star she is today? Well, believe it or not, guys, it was none other than our Toronto Argos. Go Argos. They just won a championship like 3 years ago, I think. I don't know. Everyone's talking about the Raptors winning, so. That's all for today's video, guys. Check out some of our more recent videos that we've done on the Migos and Miley Cyrus, to name a few. As always, drop a comment down below with who you guys would like to see next, or just DM me on Instagram or Twitter @Bronst7. My name is Jared Bronstein, and we'll see you guys in the next one.